Welcome, Classic Rock fans, to a short video where we get to discuss all the box sets that we're anticipating for this year. We'll prod those three wise monkeys of classic rock, the rumoured, the confirmed, and the merely hoped for. Well, we'll be asked once more to perhaps sell a kidney to indulge in this strange hobby, obsession perhaps. Nevertheless, anything that helps us deal with the chilly frostings of January is welcome in my books. So 2023 was an excellent year for the Fab Four. We got remixes of the classic Red and Blue albums, not to mention a new song now and then, which plucked at our heartstrings as we approached Christmas. Unfortunately, they did miss the opportunity to mark the 60th anniversary of a fine, fine album, which is the Please Please Me record, their debut album, which was originally conceived of as a live LP. But eventually decided to produce this music in the controlled atmosphere that was the studio. I have a great video coming up for Please Please Me, so keep your eyes peeled for that. But this year there are millions of hearts beating in unison for the announcement of the Rubber Soul Deluxe set. Something in the similar to the Revolver set, I think something like that. Which, in my opinion, I think Rubber Soul is the band's best album, where they explore an eclectic range of instrumentation, folky textures, and songs that deviate from the usual boy-girl relationship milieu of 60s pop. Also, Peter Jackson is said to be working on the band's Star Club tapes, employing AI technology to see what he can do with those recordings, which would be absolutely wonderful to hear that done. No announcement on that yet, just merely that he's working on them. And of course, in February, we're seeing the Richu McCartney's Band on the Run. I don't really see anything here that will make me part of my hard-earned for that, especially as the last edition I bought is perfectly sufficient for me. But for me, the most exciting prospect is the reissue of Mind Games, the Super Deluxe set. This Lennon's 1973 album will be released in June, I believe, and it will comprise of 4 CDs, 2 Blu-rays, as well as a 288-page hardcover weighty old tome published by Thomas and Hudson. This, according to the blurb, is going to offer the definitive exploration told in revelatory detail of the writing, recording and release of this celebrated and magical fourth solo album. The Mind Games book will be released on the 4th of June 2024 with the actual box sets expected shortly thereafter. So let's look at the other box sets that are coming out. One of the items I'm really looking forward to is Rick Wakeman, The Prog Years. This is a humongous tome comprised of lots and lots of unreleased music and concerts and lots of swag items. That comes out in February. And for metal fans, there are the Lost Tapes by Motorhead, a CD box set. I think this has been available on vinyl. They're finally getting a CD box set release for us CD fans like myself. I think these come out next month. And the big one for me is Black Sabbath, the Tony Martin years. This has been confirmed by Tony Iommi. In fact, he said on his website, "Last year when I did my message, I did say we had a box set coming out," said Iommi after a warm holiday greetings to his many fans. "Well, now I'm being informed that it will be out in May. It's been held up with paperwork and legal stuff, but anyway, it's coming out in May now. If you're interested, and I hope you are." This, of course, is a much maligned era of Sabbath, much undervalued, I think, and I can't wait to explore this set. Hopefully they've been remixed and stripped of a lot of those 1980s production values. Also, while we're on the topic of Sabbath, I would love to see a remix of the Born Again album, another much maligned album. I love the songs on that record. I love Ian Gillan's voice. I love the union of his voice and the usual Sabbath sludge. Unfortunately, the album, you put it on, it sounds like a collection of recorded demos. So I really hope that there's going to be a remix of that record. I think for a lot of Sabbath fans, they were very dismissive of any material that didn't include Ozzy. I think Dio was kind of warmly embraced, but because he was such a colossal voice and presence. And if you read Dio's autobiography, he states that it was his deteriorating relationship with Geezer Butler and Tony Iommi that was the problem there. And Cherry Red, over the next few months, are releasing some fascinating box sets that are definitely going to be worth checking out. Nectar Recycled 5 CD Remastered and Expanded box set that comes out in March. The one I'm really looking forward to is Nina Simone Blackbird, the Coal Picks recordings from 1959 to 63. This is an 8 CD set that also comes out in March. And if you like a bit of 80s pop, there's Kim Wilde, Love Blonde, The Rack Years from 81 to 83. That's a 4 CD set. That comes out next month. Colosseum Elegy, the recordings, 1968-71, six CD box set. That comes out in February. One of the most exciting ones, of course, is Jack Bruce, Smiles and Grins, broadcast sessions, 1970-2001. That's a four CD and two Blu-ray video set. That comes out sometime this month, later this month. In terms of other reissues that are coming out, I've heard rumours of a Bowie box set that's due to be announced, but say no more. Also, Jethro Tull, it marks the 40th anniversary of their divisive Under Wraps album. We haven't had any announcement, but I'd be surprised if that doesn't come out this year. I know Broadsword was delayed, but I'm hoping this one comes out to mark the 40th anniversary of this album. Some people say that the Cold War espionage themes of this album are significantly dated, but we can warm our cockles at the prospect in 2024 of going back down that road. Hopefully for this reissue, there'll be a stripping away of that horrible drum sound and we get two mixes, the original mix and a new mix with a real drummer. And yes, Regaldas were a wonderful edition of the Yes album. This is a wonderful set, and a wonderful set that marks Steve Howe's joining of this band, and very much kind of is the beginning of their 70s sound. But my hope for this year is that we get Fragile given the same sort of treatment. Likewise, The Lamb Lies Down on Broadway reaches its 50th anniversary. Are we going to get a box set? Given the band's track record on this, I very much doubt it. We'll have to just be content with going to see Steve Hackett performing a huge chunk of this music in concert this year. And of course, Queen celebrate the 50th anniversary of their finest album, in my opinion, which is Sheer Heart Attack. Are we going to get a box set to mark that? One that includes live stuff, even if it's already been released, and programs and tickets and all the usual paraphernalia. I'd like to see that. Something that celebrates the release of this high camp tour de force from one of the 20th century's greatest bands. One of my subscribers has written that they hope to see the release of Pink Floyd, The Wall Live at Earl's Court film, full show. The technology, I believe, exists to bring the material up to broadcast standard. And you're absolutely right, the technology does exist. But what doesn't exist is the will for any spirit of cooperation between Gilmour and Waters. And as this album is very much considered Waters' baby, I don't think Gilmour's going to be particularly that enthusiastic about getting it out there. Plus, he's not going to want The Wall overshadowing his solo release and probably the announcement of a tour. One of my subscribers has even mentioned The Stones and says, I'd love an emotional rescue box set with all the demos and alternate takes of the period. If not, an anniversary box set for its only rock and roll would also be welcomed. With all finished and unfinished tracks from the sessions, they could include live performances from the 75 US tour too. Well, gosh, you're expecting a huge set there. Certainly I'd like to see a deluxe set of Black and Blue, which would include the many live recordings I believe that do exist, and live video footage sort of remastered and upscaled for that set. I'd love to see that, because I really enjoy that album. Like you, I also like the Stones' disco period, as I call it. I love Emotional Rescue. And mind you, I'm a huge fan of Undercover. I'd like to see a massive box set for Undercover. I think more likely this year's we'll get a box set celebrating its only rock and roll, as that marks its 50th anniversary. And I'll be interviewing Kenny Jones, and I can't wait to ask him about drumming on that famous iconic Stones number. And Bruce Springsteen's Born to Run, I'd love to see a deluxe 50th anniversary set of that. Yes, I know there was a 30th anniversary set, but I'm sure Springsteen's got a load of stuff still tucked under his bed, really, that he could pull out for another fan fleecing. And talking of fan fleecing, Kiss, the 50th anniversary of their debut album. Expect a huge deluxe set for that, including those pesky Wicked Leicester demos from 73, 74, whenever they were done. I'm sure this will come out. Not that Kiss really ever care about the money, of course. It's purely about the fans. So there you are. That's my box set video for this year. That's what I anticipate will come out. So I will just say, please do click like, subscribe, and share this video. It makes a huge difference to the growth of this channel. And it also tickles the YouTube algorithm's bollocks, shall we say. So I will leave you with my closing salvo, which is hope you're well, staying safe, and that you keep listening.